Winter is coming.
Why so serious?
There has been an awakening. The dark side. And the light.
Say my name.
Ben. Ben Kenobi?
You're goddamn right.
Hello, welcome to Supergirl Season 2, Episode 3 recap. Welcome to Earth. I'm going to be talking positive, negative, and one WTF moments. Okay, let's get into my positives. We met Maggie Sawuer today. She's a police officer from DC Comics. Usually found in Superman comics, I believe. But I guess they wanted to bring her onto Supergirl, who works with aliens, trying to find the good aliens, not so much hunting the bad ones like the DEO. We get a tiny bit more with Lena Luthor. She is the subject of Kara's first article. Lena invented a device that is supposed to find in that, what is that word? That, uncovers aliens. Just by people touching them. And Kara has to review it. I'm really liking Lena Luthor so far. If she is evil, she's doing a really good job fooling everyone. She's good. I'm really liking her relationship with Kara so far. There's an alien drinking water hole that I found interesting. Alien says, go there, you have a drink at the end of a hard day. Seems like a really cool place. We find out a little more about that Kryptonian that landed in the season finale. Apparently he's not really Kryptonian, no. He's Taxon. Sister planet of Krypton. Well, thank you. The two planets are kind of rivals. Back in the day, now, this is just a hunch. I might be completely off base here, but this is a CW show. I have a feeling we're going to get a Romeo and Juliet relationship with Kara. I'm out now. Alright. We also got to meet the President of the United States for National City. Yeah. And then it's being played by none other than the television version 1960s Wonder Woman, Lynda Carter. And there was a nice little nod to the Wonder Woman character towards the end of the episode. Okay. We get to see Miss Martian on screen for the first time ever. In live action, I mean. Pretty damn cool if you ask me. Okay, I only have two things I had minor issues with. Okay, so, at one point of the episode, the DEO think they found, at the time, the bad Kryptonian. Without telling Killer, Alex takes her team and goes, oh, you'll find him. What is she going to do without Killer? Well, how are they going to, they didn't have Kryptonite weapons on them, no. So how were they going to fight them, him? And then it's a minor nitpick. And I could live with it, but it kind of stuck out on me. Like, really? You shouldn't have told Killer. Okay. And my last thing, minor nitpick. When the bad woman was spinning fire, the fire CGI looked awful. But that's one of those drawbacks of leaving CBS and coming to the CW. Granted, there were much more highlights of them moving to the CW, crossing over maybe easing and all that, and all for sure are now in one place, great, not complaining. But they have a lower budget. Like I said, minor nitpick. Probably should touch on the villain. I don't think we even got the villain's name. But she was a bad alien. Yeah. It was a weak villain. But I think this episode was more to introduce the possibility of good aliens. And, like I said, to introduce us to Maggie Sawuer and the Wandering Hole. And Miss Martian. But really solid episode. I love when looking at that CEO. He fits in. He's Supergirl's Cisco. And he's an overall good episode. Not great, but good. And you know what? I didn't miss Superman. They did a good job moving on from him. So, I give this episode out of 10, 3.5. Well, good episode, villain weak. It is, I think better, but pretty, really good episode. Alright, that would do it for season 2, episode 3. Welcome to Earth. We have a hero tonight. I think of Will Smith. Well, let me do it for my Supergirl recap. I'll be back tomorrow night with my Flash recap. Until then, this is Ben. Bye.